breakthrough. Why don't you clap your hands like you're slapping the devil? You're running from the devil, and the devil's scared of you. The harvest is here, baby. Come on, victory. I said the harvest is here. God's releasing revelation. God is releasing the spirit of wisdom. God is releasing souls from the east. I said he's releasing souls from the east. Why don't you clap your hands? I see souls coming. I see souls coming. And if you don't stop, release them. He just don't make promises, but he keeps his word. And so God said, I've been watching your praise to see will you praise me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because your praise says,
thank you, Lord.
I trust you. Thank you, Jesus. Even when I can't trust you.
Teach.
God, I don't know what you're doing. I don't know why you shifted. I don't know why they acted funny. I don't know why they start tripping. I don't know why they won't take my call. I don't know why. I don't know why. I don't know why. I don't know why. God had you in the dark because he was developing you. And your friends, you wish they would just shut up because every time they talk, it sounds stupid to you. Am I the only one?
Yes, sir.
And they can't give you a word of comfort because they've never been where you've been.
Jesus.
And though it looks similar, God's doing something else and he's working something else in me. And they're trying to talk like Job's friend, huh? Us.
Jesus.
Say, God.
God. Lord have mercy.
Let me teach for a minute. In the book of Genesis, here's Adam. Everybody say Adam.
Adam.
A father.
Thank you, Father.
Adam used to meet with God in the cool of the evening. It's Adam and God, and God and Adam. They had a love affair. And the devil hates when you have relationship with God. That's why every time you come out of prayer, some dumb call comes.
Come on now.
Somebody talking stupid. Some bill collector. Right after you come out of prayer, grandchildren say something crazy. Break your good china, come on here. Right after prayer. Adam met with God in the cool of the day. It's Adam and God. And God walked with Adam. And God reports love on Adam. Adam reports love on God. And they had relationship.
Yes.
They had fellowship. But because of sin, everybody says sin.
Sin.
It broke the fellowship.
Oh,
yeah. That's why if you sin, don't wallow in it. Jump up and repent.
Yeah.
It don't take a whole lot of time.
It's good, listen.
You just repent. Which means I'm sorry, I ain't doing that no more, and I don't do it no more.
Yes, sir.
Let me keep moving.
Come on.
The sin separated Adam from God. And we no longer see God coming to the earth. The Bible says now the voice of the Lord comes upon. Cain heals his brother Abel. God doesn't come. The voice comes walking. And I don't care if you go to the whorehouse or the bar, the voice will find you where you are. And I only want that the voice found where he found you. Where the voice found you. Oh, come on, you look for God. How muddy we were, and he took the blood and wash us in the blood. Don't you forget, let the boys count you in. And the Bible says, the next time you see God, Genesis chapter 11, and they build a tower, and God comes down to divide them into languages because they were building things that were not of God, and God released a vision, and he returned. The next time we see God coming to the earth, Genesis chapter 15, he visits a man by the name of Abram. He comes in the dream and makes covenant with him. After the sacrifice, after the tithe is given, and there's covenant that's made with Abraham. I'm going somewhere. Because there is no worship without sacrifice. I said there is no worship without sacrifice. You can't tell me you're worshiping and it didn't cost you nothing. You can't tell me you're worshiping and it didn't cost you something. It will cost you something when you worship. It may cost you a relationship. It may cost you, come on up in here, when you're a true worshiper. Worship is a lifestyle, and there's some people that will walk away from you when you are a worshiper. But baby, it's all right. Everything you lost, you won't get it back. I can't hear enough praying. Bible says in chapter 18, I'm moving. Chapter 18 now, we see the Lord comes down. The Lord comes down. He comes down with two angels walking to the tent with Abraham. Somebody said, the Lord. He's back on the earth. Oh, come on up in here. The Lord is back visiting the earth. And the Bible says, and the Lord was with Abraham.
Yeah.
And the Lord was with Abraham. And the Lord was with Isaac. And the Lord was with Jacob. And the Lord was with. And the Lord is with Pastor Hawkins. Negotiator. Jacob, who has a generational spirit of telling lies. You ever found folks to tell lies?
Yes, sir.
That was Jacob. You ever seen a family that everybody had children out of wedlock? Yes. See, we're quiet now.
Yes.
Those are called generational curses. And all of our families have some form of dysfunction. It's called the human race. Are you hearing me? But the good news is when the Lord is with you, he will change your nature. Well, the stuff that you had to do, you don't have to do it anymore. Come on up in here. I'm going somewhere. When you have an encounter, not an experience, because we have people who come into the altar and they're crying, but they haven't had an encounter. When you have an encounter with God, he changes your nature. Where you used to cuss folk out, when you used to hit your big toe and cuss, now you say, Jesus. Come on here. He changes your nature. When you used to steal, now you give. When you used to lie, now you tell the truth. When you used to do evil, now you do good. I'm talking to Zion. I'm talking to the people who said, I don't do what I used to do. He has changed me. Do I have any people that realize that even when I was saved, I wasn't, hallelujah, transformed like I should have been, and but yet he's still working on me? Don't you get wonderful in here? Don't you get grand? You better say like Zion, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I would have been destroyed. If it had not been for the Lord, I would have died in the bar. Come on. I would have died over an overdose. But now he has kept me, and I'm in my right mind. and I'm in good health. Jacob. Everybody said Jacob.
Jacob.
Jacob, Jacob. In Jacob's defense, he had to wrestle for everything he had. There was a struggle. Every time Jacob wanted a house, it was a struggle. When he wanted a wife, it was a struggle. When the stuff, it was a struggle. Everything, working for the father-in-law, struggle. Business, struggle. But one day, the Bible says that Jacob was alone with God. And God came and began to wrestle. Began to wrestle with the man Jacob. How many know you will have a day of visitation? But God's waiting for you to come to a place of isolation. When everybody walk out on you. Then God walks in. Jacob was alone. He left the children here. He left the wife here. And it was just Jacob and God. And God came to visit him. How many know there is a visitation of God? And God's waiting for you to come to the place of isolation. And when you come to that place of isolation, he's going to give you revelation to deal with your situation, to break every limitation for his glorification. Come on and clap your hands and say, yes, Lord.